In this video, we want to explore a very aggressive and probably also very unpopular idea. What if China decided to just blatantly copy Starship? Could they actually do it?
Would they have a chance to build their own starships in order to colonize the Moon and Mars with their own taikonauts? Well, let's find out!
We all know that Starship is the single most transformative space vehicle in all of human history. Some still try to deny it. Some still try to convince themselves that it will be vehicles like SLS or Orion, or even the lobbyist moon lander from lobbyist companies such as Blue Origin, Boeing, or Lockheed, who will be humanity's best chance for colonizing space. But everyone who understands even a slight bit of economics and spaceflight will understand that the only vehicle which will allow us to colonize the Moon, Mars, and other destinations on a massive scale will be Starship. Once Starship becomes available, it will make all other rockets completely obsolete. This is not an exaggeration. It's the simple truth. Ariane, obsolete. Soyuz, obsolete. Delta IV Heavy, obsolete. Starship will reduce the costs of colonizing the Moon by a factor of at least 1,000. Of colonizing Mars, probably by a factor of more than 10,000. And funny enough, all space companies or institutions seem to completely ignore Starship. Only NASA seems to acknowledge the vast potential of Starship by awarding a small chunk to SpaceX for developing a moon version of Starship for the Artemis program. ESA built Ariane 6, which won't be reusable. ULA's first rocket, where only the engines are reusable, is still years away.
Blue Origin's reusable New Glenn rocket, which is shown off time and time again in fancy CGI animations, is also years away. It seems that they all don't understand what will await them once Starship is complete. It will be total annihilation, total domination, total destruction for all other space launch providers and companies. And it seems that the only ones on this entire planet who understand how important it is to develop reusable rockets are, get this, the Chinese. Yes, they are the only ones on this entire planet who are already working on reusable rockets. China only sent the first people into space not even 20 years ago. They are the latecomers, so to speak. How then can it be that they are the only ones who seem to understand the potential of reusability? There are quite a few Chinese startups already working on reusable rockets. And of course they are just trying to blatantly copy SpaceX. Of course we can rant on how China is copying everything, but let's be brutally honest here. At least they are smart enough to copy SpaceX in the first place, which is already far ahead of ULA, Roscosmos, and the European Space Agency. Really far ahead, because they still pretend that non-reusable rockets have a chance, when in fact non-reusable rockets are inbound to be absolutely disrupted. And say what you will about the Chinese, but at least they seem to understand how important reusability is. So they have iSpace and LinkSpace, their two biggest private companies, which are trying to replicate SpaceX's success by basically developing their own versions of the Falcon 9. iSpace is the first Chinese private company who was able to launch two small satellites into orbit on the 25th of July 2019.
This rocket here, called Hyperbola 1, is not reusable yet, and has a very small LEO payload capacity of only 260 kilograms. But iSpace has big plans. Their next launch vehicle, the Hyperbola 2, which they say will be completed and ready for launch in 2021, will be fully reusable and much more capable. This rocket here is basically a weird version of a Falcon 9. They even copy the grid fins from SpaceX. Like SpaceX's Starship, It will use liquefied methane and oxygen as fuel, and be capable of sending 1.9 metric tons to low Earth orbit. The rocket itself is 28 meters tall and has a weight of 90 metric tons. iSpace even has plans for a reusable space plane. However, it seems that LinkSpace is further ahead than iSpace, where iSpace shows fancy CGI and pretty renderings. So they are basically the Chinese version of Blue Origin. LinkSpace already has tested reusable rockets in hopping tests. They started with really small tethered demonstrators, went to untethered low-altitude hopping tests, until at some point, they were able to demonstrate hopping tests with their RLV-T5 demonstrator. This rocket performed a 300-meter hopping test on August 10, 2019. And if you think, those two talk about some interesting stuff about rockets, space, Tesla, and even sometimes boring tunnels and Hyperloop, we would be uber thankful. Yes, uber thankful if you would subscribe to our channel and stay up to date on those topics.
The next rocket which they currently develop is the SRV-1. Now, we're not sure what SRV stands for, but SRV was probably the coolest guitar player of all time, so, you know, we really like that name. It will be a suborbital reusable rocket, which will also use liquid oxygen and methane as propellant. The bigger one will be the New Line 1, which looks suspiciously like a mixture between a Falcon 9 and New Glenn. The height will be 24 meters with a weight of 42 metric tons and a payload capacity of 200 kilograms. So yes, it seems that the Chinese companies really want to build their own versions of the Falcon 9. Now sure, they are far behind. Their RLV-T5 hopping test shows that they are currently where SpaceX was already 7 years ago, when they tested their Grasshopper test rocket. It is incredible that this here was only 7 years ago, and now SpaceX is flying astronauts to the ISS, has even launched the Falcon Heavy 3 times, and even has the giant Starship in development. So the Chinese space companies are now where SpaceX was in 2013. And since China seems to understand that reusable rockets are important, what if they decided to not only copy the Falcon, but also to copy Starship?
Because they probably know that when Starship comes to life, their whole space program will become a total joke overnight. Everything China has will be really so inferior to Starship that it's not even funny anymore. And since the new Cold War seems to be developing between the US and China, China knows fully that they will not be allowed to use Starship for their own missions. But Europe, Japan, and other collaborative nations will be allowed to use Starship for their own space missions. So they of course don't want to miss out. Therefore, what if they just blatantly copy Starship? The development of Starship at Boca Chica is totally open. Everyone around the world can watch the development. Amazing people like Lab Pedro or Boca Chica Gal make all these amazing recordings of what's going on at Boca Chica for everyone to see. So China certainly also knows what's happening at Boca Chica with Starship and Super Heavy. So could they actually copy Starship? Or are they even already in the process of copying Starship? Well, we can give the all clear. Even if China already started copying Starship, which we are quite sure they didn't, even then, they would be years behind SpaceX. Right now, China is not even capable of having anything near the capability of a Falcon 9, let alone a Falcon Heavy.
The Chinese National Space Agency is still relying on non-reusable rockets, whereas NASA is now using Falcon 9s for their crewed missions to the ISS. By the time Starship will land on the moon, LinkSpace or iSpace might be using their first generation reusable rockets, which will be extremely far behind Starship. Also, they don't have anything remotely, even remotely near the capability which the Raptor engine has. And we all know it wasn't easy to get the full flow staged combustion working properly at an insane chamber pressure of up to 300 bar. This was not an easy feat. But no, China would also need to replicate all the intricate steel alloys SpaceX is experimenting with, and they would also need to replicate the entire fabrication process, which, as we know, is insanely difficult. So at best, and this is now best case, China could have a Starship-like vehicle by around 2030. And this is best case, more likely 2035. So yes, there is no need to worry. China will not have their own starships with an extremely high likelihood of, we'd say, 99% at least in this decade.
However, does this mean we should underestimate China? Absolutely not. Make no mistake. Even though they are not working on their own starships, they plan on landing taikonauts on the moon by 2030. They plan on building a moon base right after that. And now Russia even plans to join them as an ally. So what they lack in innovative space vehicles, they make up for with determination and a long-term plan to build a moon base. That's why Starship is so important. The US will gain total space domination once they have Starship and Super Heavy, thanks to SpaceX.
And yes, not thanks to Boeing, for which some really cool viewers made up some absolutely hilarious acronyms, and also not thanks to Lockheed, and also not thanks to Northrop, and also not thanks to Draper, and also not thanks to Blue Origin. Only thanks to SpaceX. Starship will be ultra transformative, and SpaceX will be always at least two, more likely three steps ahead of China. If China should have their own Starship by 2035, SpaceX will already have Starship 2.0 or 3.0 and a huge armada of Starships 1.0. So yes, the scenario of China surprising everyone with their own versions of Starship is really not realistic. You can all sleep well knowing that SpaceX is far ahead of anyone else.
And if you want to learn more about how Starship will help us to build our first Mars city, you can check out this video right here.
So thanks as always for watching the JS Space Report, and then I would say, on to the future. So then thanks as always for watching, and then we'd say,
the JS Space Report.
So
Hyperbola one or what?
Hyperbola.